In the previous chapter, we were learning about forms of business organization: sole proprietorship, partnership, joint stock company, etc., etc. And if you are analyzing, if you are looking into it, one common feature you can find is that all those business organizations were controlled or owned by private parties or individuals, either an individual or a group of individuals. Now, there are some another forms of business organization where ownership is in hands of government. And in this chapter, in this new chapter, we will be learning about something of that kind. Before that, we have to understand, that's a question posed to you. What kind of economy do India have? Or if you are looking at the business organizations in India, you can see a feature that there are business organizations which are owned by private parties, as well as there are business organizations which are owned and managed by government too. So, Indian economy is said to be a mixed economy. Indian economy is said to be a mixed economy because here in Indian economy, both the private parties and public parties are allowed or they are found doing business. So, in this chapter, we will be learning about the forms of business organization under public sector. So, for your understanding, to understand this chapter, we have to understand what is meant by public sector and private sector. That is the two sectors of our economy. Public sector consists of all organizations which are owned, operated and controlled by government. Either they will be fully or they will be partially owned by either state government or central government. That means ownership will be in the hands of government. So such kind of organization which are owned and managed by government, we call it by the name private sector. That's a different sector. And what is public sector? What is private sector? What is private sector? Private sector are those organizations which are owned by individual or group of individuals. That means purely it is a single person or a group of persons. They merely will be looking at the profit, making profit. But when you are looking at the public sector is for accelerating growth of economy or accelerating growth of country. They will be focusing. Of course, they will be making profit also, but they have one more aim or one more idea is there. They are accelerating the economy, economic growth in country also. So, if you are looking at Indian economy, you can find both this public and private sector. So, public sector is that set of organization which are owned by government, and private sector is that sector where organization are owned by private individuals. So, when you are coming to this chapter, that is the third chapter, we are starting with the third chapter. Third chapter is talking about the private, public, private and global enterprises. But even though chapter's name is that big, private enterprises we have already learned in the previous chapter. The forms of organizing business organization under private sector was learned in the second chapter, where you have learned sole proprietorship, partnership, joint stock company. All those things are forms of joining or forms of running private sector businesses. When you are coming to public sector business, you can see that there are also forms of business organizations are there, in which always public sector can be formed. And this gained importance after 1947 only, or public sector came into being after 1947, because the time of Britishers, they were mainly focused in some cities, say Calcutta or Bombay or Madras. These were the cities they were focusing on. Rest of the places were lagging behind. So when new government of our own Indians came, their prime aim was to develop the country in total. So, and some of the business areas were private individuals were not able to handle. Government intervened. That the result we can see in Bhilai, Roorkela and all, heavy steel, heavy machinery plants. So heavy plants came into being. That was to make sure that government is making sure equal development of country and business is encouraged. You can see in 5-year plans, industry, development of industry was given preference in more than 1 5-year plans you can see. So it was for development. So public sector or government is entering into business because of the reason that they want to develop country, or they want to make sure that the general public is able to get better resources or better requirements fulfilled. So they came into business to make ensure that economic growth is there, equal development is there, everyone is getting better services. All these things was the idea behind government entering into business. So the forms which they opted, which they adopted for entering into business area or forms of business organization in public sector was of three kinds. Forms of public sector enterprises. Three ways government entered into business. One was departmental undertaking. Departmental undertaking. Departmental undertaking is nothing. It is form of business organization where government is forming an organization as an extension of ministry. As an extension of ministry or as a part of ministry that a business organization is coming into being. That is departmental undertaking. Second one is statutory corporation. Statutory corporation is a form whereby a business organization is brought into existence by passing an act in the parliament. Statutory corporation. And the third one is government company. Government company is same as joint stock company. Only thing is that government is have either having 100% of shares or more than 51% of shares in a joint stock company. That company will be called a government company. Or these are the three ways in which government is entering into business or forms of public sector enterprises. The rest of the things we will see in detail in next classes.